Section 1.1, we are going to be identifying points, lines, and planes. Looking at the basic points of geometry, it comes from those three definitions. Now, a point has no physical dimensions, and it's represented by a dot, which we've seen before in previous classes. The other definitions are here on the screen. We have a line where it is represented by two dots, and it has arrowheads going in both directions, which means it goes on and on into infinity in both directions. And if we were to represent this line, we would call this line AB. As a subset, we have two other categories that are in the line family, one of which is array, and the other one is a line segment. Now, array has a specific stopping point on one side, and then it goes forever on the other side. So, if we're looking at this little chart here with the line, let's say that I was going to start at point A, and I was going to go all the way to point B to infinity. So, it has a stopping point at point A, and then it goes on to infinity to just the one side. It would represent array. In this instance, it would be array AB, and it would make sure that the arrow is going towards the arrow that is going on the array and drawn. The other one is a line segment. A line segment has an actual specific dimension. All right, we can measure that because it has two stopping points. So if I were to erase this here and say, all right, I got AB, there's a stopping point here and a stopping point here, and I can measure this. The line segment has two specific endpoints, and it would represent the line segment as the line segment AB, which is the line on top of the arrowheads at all. So those are the differences. Finally, we have planes. Planes it's a two-dimensional figure. Usually, it's represented as a parallelogram, because that's what we have here. So, it's represented as a parallelogram. Looks like a floor, and it can be represented by either three points, which in this case is points A, B, and C, which they're on the plane. And you could also give it a name, like, for instance, we could just say this is plane P, or whatever name you choose to give that. And those are the two different ways that you can name a plane. Now, plane, you know, the easiest way to look at that visually is probably, you know, taking a piece of paper and like placing things on top of the piece of paper, saying that those items are on the plane. We'll get more into details as the chapter goes along in this portion. Some other terms we're going to look at are collinear points and coplanar points. So collinear points are points that lie on the same line. And so if you just look at the definition itself, it says collinear. The word linear is in there. Linear, when we talked about in algebra, linear equations, we talked about a straight line. Alright, so anytime you talk about linear, you're talking about lines. So we have to find all the points that lie on that line. And then same thing with coplanar points. Coplanar points are points that lie on the same plane. Again, the word planar is in the word. So if I got this here, I got looks like points. Looks like I got points. F. I got points X. I got points Y. Finally, point Q. And for lines, I have line X, Z. You could also name that line M because it was represented like that. So there's actually two ways to represent a line. You could use the points that are on the line, or you could give it a general name regardless. And another line would be line RQ. Planes. It looks like there's only one. That's the deal parallel, and you can call it just plain R because of the little corner there. Or you can identify it by the 3 points. So I can say quarter plane. Now all you have to do is identify 3 points that are on the plane. So I can say F X. Is there other points on there? Yeah, but you know, these ones are, and you can use that to identify. Also, let's take a look at some. Do we have any coordinator points? Well, let's take a look. So I got a line that's here, and I have a line that's here. So looking at the first one, I identified originally as line XZ, and looks like the points that lie on that line are X, Y, Z. And for the other line, which is line YQ, the points on that line are YQ. So those are my collinear points for this example. If I were to look at coplanar points, I have all the points that lie on the plane. Now, looks like for coplanar points here, I could say that point X, point F, point Y, and point Z are all points that lie on the plane. Now, the one that does not is point Q. Point Q is not on the plane. Right? It's outside of it or on top of it. Orientation is for this particular problem. Okay. So, talk about is intersections. Intersections, the basic definition is where items cross. Okay. And in this instance, there are three different types of intersections. This one's a line line. This one's a line. Intersect these items creates a certain characteristic, whether it's going to be like a line point. So in this case, when two lines intersect, they intersect and make a point. When a line and plane intersects, I also get. Finally, when two planes intersect, I get a line segment. Okay. So, one of the things I want to look at is this right here. I have these little dashed lines. They're supposed to be called, this is what's represented, what is called hidden. That are part of the geometry, but you don't see them because it covers up. In this instance, it's covered up by the plane. And so, in order to represent it, represents a dashed line. What's talking about that is sections. And then finally, they want us to sketch a situation between ABC. Intersects plane XYZ. Okay, so pretty similar to what we have up top, but except we're just going to identify things. And remember, we're looking at drawing planes. Remember, planes are represented as parallelograms. So I'm going to make a parallelogram. Let's identify some points. So, excuse me, I